In our last session, we did NAND designing, XOR designing, multiplexer designing of using Tanner EDA software tool. Till now, we designed the schematic circuit diagram. Layout, we will discuss soon. Today, we are going to discuss the VHDL programming. I must say, this particular VHDL programming, you have already been done in your 7th semester theory paper. So you are quite familiar with the syntax and all. Here we will do the practical execution of VHDL circuit. As you are, this is a first practical, that is a design and implement the logic gates and evaluate the number of gate area and participation. Before making the designing part, programming part, one must know that what are these logic gates. I do agree from second year you are studying the logic gate, digital electronics, but once you go through this, first is an AND gate, A dot B, that is going to be Y. This is the characteristic equation. When any input is 0, my output is going to be 0. And it is only going to be 1 when my both input are going to be 1. XOR, these two circuit, why I draw first, because these both we design in a schematic also. And XOR, XNOR, and this. Fine. Now we will move ahead. First of all, we are designing the two input AND gate. Fine. Two input AND gate means A and B is my input and Y is my output. As you know, the VHDL programming practice, first of all we include library. So the mandatory library is use IEEE STD underscore logic underscore 1164 dot all. What it includes? It includes all the values which your VHDL can analyze and operate, and arithmetic and unsigned. These are optional. If you want to add them, then also your particular program is going to be run. Then comes entity. Entity is where the part where I am defining my input and output. So port A, B is my in, which is type STD logic. I once again recalling you, what is my STD logic? STD logic is a parameter which contains the 0 to 9 characteristics. Means apart from 0 and 1, there are many other input and output which can I can assign in my VHDL programming, like high 0, low 0, weak 1, don't care, high impedance, and so many. Fine. So that is why I am assigning bit STD logic. But it is not mandatory. You can assign it as a bit, boolean, integer. And what are these? These are my data types. Fine. Here I define my inputs. Then architecture is what part? Where I show IO relationship. IO relationship means, what is my Y? Y is nothing but ending of A and B. So A and B. That's it, is my programming. After executing this programming, next we will discuss later. After this programming, when I run my program, what I will get? Such RTL schematic I get if I successfully running the program. Fine. And after this, if you click on a simulation button, you will get this waveform. Now see here, verify your inputs 00, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, but 1, 1, 1. Hence my designing of AND gate is justified. One more circuit we will discuss. Leave the NAND gate. We will discuss the XNOR. XNOR means what? AB plus A bar B bar. This should be my Y. Fine. So here also, again we will define all these library. And one line is skip here. I am sorry. That is library. IEEE. that you need to mention. And each statement, see, pay attention, is terminated by this semicolon. Defining entity is going to be same. And here I am using data flow designing. Which designing? Data flow design. Soon we will discuss another designing methods in the architecture, that is one is behavioral, another is structural.